Regional flavours will take place from July 21 to 22 and will even have live cooking demonstrations.
There will be more than 80 stalls to satisfy your taste buds. So bring your friends and an appetite. Kaylee Carew, 10 Eyewitness News.
Not only is it just screen and media students getting involved, but also beauty, music and building design students.
6,000 people signed a petition for the kiosk to remain on Queen Street Mall, but it still wasn't enough to persuade the Brisbane City Council.
That decision under fire today.
I would say that maybe need to be in touch with the people of Brisbane a little bit more.
Rick Kurzweil was having breakfast when he noticed his two dogs suddenly fighting for life.
So one of my dogs came upstairs and she was looking funny and then she kind of fell downstairs. Then I came outside and I noticed that my other dog, the back legs were like paralysed.
Both of Rick's dogs died, but other pets have also been targeted in the area. His neighbours finding a suspicious package in their yard.
It was like a white mesh bag with looking like little mothballs or beanbaggy sort of things and said, "What's this? I've just taken this off the dog."
There are concerns the white powder-like substance is the highly toxic strychnine. People are linking these poisonings to recent break-ins.
And they had some of these little white beads floating around and didn't think anything of it, blew them away that night. It just coincided that her car was broken into.
The news has spread quickly via social media.
And it's also sadness for the people who are actually doing it. Mm. Because if their lives are that messed up, that they've got to take this action to survive, that's pretty sad altogether.
Members of the community are now fearing that toddlers could be the next victims of this deadly toxin.
The RSPCA is investigating the incidents and anyone with any information is asked to come forward. Kaylee Carew, 10 Eyewitness News.
From coasts and hinterland to the Australian bush, glamping experiences are appearing everywhere, with the word itself added to the Oxford Dictionary just 2 years ago. Now this is what I call camping. Cheers.
If you want to give glamping a go, you'll be spending around $300 a night. Get in quick, and it could just be the perfect Mother's Day gift. Kaylee Carew, QUT News.
But Minister Stirling Hinchliffe has up to 28 days to make the decision and says he won't be rushed.
An alternative which was included in the council's submission is for the state to assign a committee that would oversee the council and report back to the minister for the next 2 years. Kaylee Carew, 10 Eyewitness News.
The secret's out. Our hinterland has become a tourist hotspot.
Visitation to Springbrook Mountain and its fantastic national parks has increased dramatically.
Remnants of Cyclone Debbie battered roads to the mountain 2 years ago. Now they're finally fixed, day trippers are coming up in droves, creating a new problem.
A car park that has only 11 car parks where visitation is coming with 50 to 60 cars is completely inadequate.
Hundreds of people visit the Talabana picnic ground every weekend. Locals fear the gridlock is an accident waiting to happen.
It literally becomes a 20-kilometre zone or less because there's too many cars, way too many people, all just hanging around.
It's a similar story at Purlingbrook Falls. It may look quiet now, but on any given weekend, the main street is full of cars.